You just presented your findings on the impact of alcohol on the incidence of breast cancer to begin with, and then after diagnosis, does it matter if you modify your intake of alcohol afterward? What role does alcohol have in the cause of breast cancer?
That is something that does increase your risk of breast
cancer. Yes, absolutely.
But most of the epidemiology data on alcohol consumption right after diagnosis or right before diagnosis suggests that it doesn't impact your outcomes after diagnosis. There is now emerging data supporting that independent of alcohol intake, binge drinking relates to breast cancer risk. And so that is something that maybe women may not want to give up alcohol completely, but the increased incidence of binge drinking and has many, many different health effects, but if that's one thing that might be more modifiable and could have a profound impact, particularly when you think about the impact of drinking prior to your first pregnancy.
What is binge drinking? What's the definition of binge drinking?
So there are a couple different definitions. A standard definition some people use is 4 drinks for women or 5 drinks for men, but sometimes that is specified during a certain window of time.
Right.
There have actually been a couple studies now supporting a measure of binge drinking by asking a woman, have you ever blacked out? And that also has been associated with breast cancer risk.
So it's really our responsibility as physicians and as mothers and as aunts and as grandmothers to raise the level of awareness about alcohol, that it's not really good for you, especially when consumed before menopause, when the breasts are maybe more vulnerable or sensitive to environmental factors, things we eat and drink and all the other things.
Exactly. So I think a couple of things that are important messages for us to think about. So one is that often in the United States, we only find out about breast cancer prevention once we're diagnosed.
Exactly.
So we do need to change that narrative and make sure that there's more widespread knowledge of breast cancer risk and chronic disease risk and in general, so that women can have more knowledge and affect their risk of disease and from a very early age to be knowledgeable about the factors. Thinking more about health in general and a healthy diet and having when alcohol is used as in moderation along with your diet.
It's a challenge, but certainly one that we can get smarter about, and your work and presentation today was very helpful.
Oh, thank you.
And it really provides that, the evidence that we can base it on, so that as we communicate this information to our own daughters and to the patients we take care of, we can do it with more credibility.
Mm-hmm.
And so thank you so much for your work.
Thank you.
And for sharing that with us at breastcancer.org.
Great, well thank you for your website.
Yes.
I love your website.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, great.